Now, listen, Johnny, you're a perfect fit for this show because we are all aware of some of the disgusting things that you've done on stage.
I know what you're making reference to. It's not something I make a habit of. The man reviewing me basically reviewed pet shows because the ones that normally review comedy didn't turn up. And all it involved was an audience member's belt, somebody walking me round, we recreated Crufts, and I said, oh, he's in trouble, and I squeezed something out.
So you thought you have...
I didn't just drop my trousers. What I did was, first, I recreated Crufts.
Needless to say, we've put some plastic sheeting under your seat just in case.
You know the green room in the BBC once? We stayed so late that my generous offer of transport home had left. And I was one of only two people left in the building. And I stole the whole, you know, the phone system from the front of the BBC.
You stole it?
Yeah. I woke up with it in my flat.
This is like therapy.
It's good, isn't it?
Did you give it back, Johnny Vegas?
I was waiting for them to ask for it back and no.
BBC for Watchdog, people trying to phone the BBC for Crime Watch, people trying to phone the BBC like myself to try and do the Blue Peter competition thing. None of them would have got through, Johnny Vegas. And for that, I applaud you. That's another minus 10 points on the wrong gong. On to you, Johnny Vegas. Come on.
If it's linked to me, it's a very loyal employer of mine.
Where were you working?
I worked at a pub, I worked at the Brown Edge. I used to pretend that I was leaving, just to have leaving parties. And I left three times to make my fortune. Well, I didn't. I left once to make my fortune in comedy and go to that bar, London. And then when I got back, I just felt undervalued as an employee, so I said I was leaving again. And he threw me another leaving party. I was already gigging in Liverpool and doing bits and bobs. I was like, look, I'm just finding it a struggle juggling the two. Carried on my bar job there and then went, now this time I'm leaving. And it was at my third leaving party and we were smashing plates in the Greek restaurant and he went, please tell me this is the time that you make your break for it. And he was the most patient employee and, you know, he showed me more generosity than my actual family and I took full advantage of it. He called us in one day and he went, we've really stuck by you. When you're collecting, when people have finished eating, what do you not do?
Get your dick out.
You don't eat the leftover roast potatoes off the plate in front of the customers. He said, it's not the image that we're trying to project here. And if you want to eat off plate, do it in the kitchen. Don't stand in front of them going, are you enjoying it? Oh, no.
Johnny.
Tell you straight off.
Come on.
Sister had a goldfish.
Lovely.
She left for college. Mm-hmm. She begged me to look after it. Within 3 weeks of going, I sold it to a local aquarium for 80p to buy some cider.
How bad is an aquarium that one of their features is an 80p goldfish?
Ah, I'm glad you asked. It wasn't just a goldfish, it was a comet tail, which she didn't know when she'd won me at the fairground. Otherwise, I'd have only got 40p and it wouldn't have been worth me time.
80p cider, though. Good on you, Johnny.
I'm looking at that fish now and it's a bit guilt. My sister had gone to college. She was lonely. She had one thing to come back for. Three brothers who she didn't get on with, but one fish. And I enjoyed telling her it was gone.
Don't go down that route, Johnny.
If you're going to do these Jerry Springer-style shows, emotions are going to erupt.